Hello, this is Dr. Cynthia Furse from the University of Utah. Today we're going to be talking about equivalent circuits. First we're going to talk about what an equivalent circuit is. It's basically a circuit that gives you the same voltage and current that another circuit would have given you. We'll talk about what it means to be series and parallel for resistance and conductance and also for voltage and current sources. We'll talk about voltage and current dividers and then equivalent sources. Equivalent circuits are two circuits that are the same if the voltage and the current characteristics at the nodes are identical. Then the circuits are considered equivalent. What does that mean? So right here are two nodes. Here's V1 and here's V2. If the currents I1, I2, and V1, V2 are the same, then it means that we have an equivalent circuit. Basically, we're going to be changing the part that's right here in the rest of the circuit so that we have two circuits that give us the same voltage and current situation. So let's see, here's a very simple example. If I had a circuit right here, notice this is the part on the left and it has two nodes, V1 and V2, and there are five resistors, R1, R2, R3, R4, and R5. If we combined all of these resistors in series, right there, we'd have an equivalent resistance. The equivalent resistance is basically just the sum of all five of the resistors, and if we did that, this circuit and this circuit would have exactly the same front end. The voltage and the current at the front would be exactly the same. These two circuits would be equivalent. So if we have circuits that are in series, it means they have the same current, as shown here at the top. If we have circuits that are in parallel, it means they have the same voltage, as shown here at the bottom. Resistors that are in series add. That's what we just did. So if we had four resistors in series, and we want to find their equivalent resistance, we just add them up. The equivalent resistance is just the sum of all four resistors. A voltage divider uses resistors in series to be able to divide up the voltage. We take the original voltage Vs and we run it across a couple of resistors, and you can see right here that one of the resistors is used to divide the voltage so that we can get V2. V2 is going to be equal to R2 over R1 plus R2, as shown here. If we had many resistors, the voltage would be the resistor that the voltage is taken across divided by all of the other resistors in series. Here's an example of the voltage divider cards that you have in your package, and you can see that we can take one voltage, such as the voltage across this battery, and divide it into two parts by running it across two resistors. Now the other thing that we can do with a voltage divider is we can take two voltages and put them together in series, so basically stack up two batteries, and we'll get the sum of the two voltages. A voltage divider works as both a voltage divider, and in the other direction as a voltage summer. So voltages in series add. Here we have three voltages in a circuit, and the way they're going to add is we'll just go in this direction. Here is minus V1 plus V2 minus V3, and so right here the voltage equivalent is V1 minus V2 plus V3. The equivalent resistance is found by summing up the two resistors that are in series, so the bottom circuit is an equivalent of the top circuit. Currents in series have to be the same or else something blows up. So this circuit that's right here, you can see we have a 6 amp in series with a 4 amp. That's an unrealizable, impossible circuit. This can't happen or else the circuit would blow up. Resistors that are in parallel add in a different way. The equivalent resistance is taken by take the inverse of each resistor, 1 divided by R1 plus 1 divided by R2 plus 1 divided by R3, and invert all of that, and that's going to be the equivalent resistance. So no matter how many resistors we have, we can find the equivalent resistance for this circuit right here. There's another way to think of that, and that's in terms of conductance. Conductance is 1 divided by the resistance. So here is the conductance, 1 divided by R1, that you can see right here. Adding up the resistors in parallel is the same thing as adding the conductance in parallel, except it's very simple. The conductances in parallel add. G equivalent is equal to G1 plus G2 plus G3. Remember that R equivalent is 1 divided by G equivalent. So this is often used in electromagnetics as well as other aspects of electrical engineering. The current divider is what happens when we have resistors in parallel. We bring in a single current, IS, and it divides into two currents, I1 and I2, according to this equation here. You can see that I1 is going to be dependent upon R2, and I2 is dependent upon R1. Here's your current divider card. Now, a current divider can also be used as a current adder. If we had one current, we could divide it into two, or if we had two currents coming in, they could be combined into one current. Now, currents can be added up in parallel, but voltages can't. So voltages in parallel have to be the same, or else the circuit blows up. Here, for example, are three different batteries. This is a 1.5-volt battery, this is a 9-volt battery, and this is a 12-volt battery. We can't put those in parallel unless they were equal, or else we would blow up our circuit. So this is also an unrealizable circuit. In order to transform a source, we often do this in order to simplify our circuit or better understand what's going on in the circuit. So if, for example, we had had a voltage source, remember how we had the voltage source card for a realistic voltage that had a resistor in series with it? If we want to convert that instead to a realistic current source, here's the transformation that we would do. IS would be VS divided by R1, and R1 and R2 in these pictures would be equal. We can go back and forth between these two equivalent circuits and have different source transformations. Now, how might we use this? I want you to take a look in your textbook at example 2-10 and go through this example in some level of detail. Basically, transforming back and forth between current and voltage sources allows us to more easily analyze this particular circuit. So we've started out with a current source and several resistors in series and in parallel. Then, if we convert the current source to a voltage source, this allows us to combine these two resistors in series. Then, if we convert this new voltage source back to a current source, that's going to allow us to more easily include these resistors in parallel, and so on until we're finished. This analysis is often done when we're doing filter design and development. So in short, we've talked about equivalent circuits. Basically, an equivalent circuit is if we have the same voltage and current at the front end, we know that two circuits are equivalent. We talked about series and parallel. Remember that resistances in series add and conductances in parallel add. Voltages can be added in series and current sources can be added in parallel, but not the other way around. We also talked about voltage and current dividers. Remember that those can also be used as summers, and then we talked about equivalent sources. The picture from the front is from the rim of Snow Canyon in St. George, Utah.